I'm streaming without bands on for a bit. I just had to like put on some extra settings on NVIDIA broadcast because it was picking up the noise of the fans after I've like adjusted them a bit. I hadn't even bothered to check if it was coming through on the previous stream. But yeah. It warm. I don't like it warm. Leave the sign there in case we get distracted, and then we remove it when we come back from climbing the mountain. Possibly didn't help that earlier I didn't have the window like all the way open, so there wasn't much opportunity for a natural breeze. Yeah, just double checking I had the humidifier turned off there. Of stinger or spitter. I think there's an alpha stinger that likes to camp around here. Anyway, it looks a little bit different. Like, this looks like a more of a sheer drop off, and I'm not sure if it's just because I haven't been up here in a while. Because normally, when I am over here, like the copper and titanium factories are sticking out. Yeah, I'm just gonna ignore them. Oh fuck, maybe. This little bacon shroom cave. If I remember correctly, the non-uniform scaling issue does apply to the mountain. But but there's a good chance that the jumping puzzles will have changed slightly. I think if we go that way around, what's this way around? Okay, so it's not that way round yet, then. Either that or it's an alternate route. Just at least initially. Come on. It's just sunbathing itself. Yeah, I don't need to finish the jumping puzzle because, like, I know there's a purple slug up there, but mostly there for the uranium node, and I don't need that yet. It needs four mortar. I don't know if that was a subconscious thing or just a lucky thing, but me handcrafting those mortars means I've got the parts for them already. Uranium node, let's keep away from that. Oh wait, there's another one. I don't know if I've gotten that on like 18C or 19B, but I think that used to be like way up there. Like it was so far out of the way that you wouldn't know it was there unless you like read the map or use the object scanner. Like me, I would only see it I just realized I forgot to update the map, didn't I? Crap. We did some crab hatches, didn't I? Hello. I think I need to like scoot out of the way a bit so I can like more or less safely update the map. Technically, that's not cleared. Has explodable rocks. Well, not what I wanted to do. Patch site in progress. Try that again. The only phone's going ding, but I'm not expecting any deliveries today. So I'm not gonna check it just yet. Oh fuck. Wait, I could hear that little arsehole following us. Let's try that again. I mean, another option to try is like leapfrogging off there onto here, but eh. Here we go. Oh, that's rapid fire. Did I misread what I saw up here? I think I might have seen that and thought crash site. Yeah, I think that's what happened there. Climbable vines up there. Thank you. Oh, yeah. Keeping away from that. Yeah, see, that does have like a similar profile from a distance to a chunk of crash site, so I'm guessing that the crash site I'm thinking of probably still up there. You know, are these vines climbable? They are, I must need a hotkey. Notable walls are new. Although saying that, I haven't really spent that much time exploring Spire Coast, so I don't know how new it is, really. Not a successful leap. Neither was that. What's going on with the keys? Very suspicious of vaguely urban areas and biomes I've not explored much. Is this where I just came from? I think it might be. There's a spitter trotting around somewhere, and I can't tell if it's upstairs or downstairs. There it is. There. We don't really have urgent need for the slugs. Oh, sunsetting. Looks weird. I forget to put the start FPS on again. Oh, there we go. I'm just gonna like quickly cheat a second. I wanna check if the crash site's up there or if I'm just, you know, wasting my time. Yeah, it looks like there's only a power slug up there. Yeah, but purple power slug. Looks like there's something in the bushes. Yeah, crab hatches. I'll build lookout towers with what I've got. I can. I don't think I've ever used these for their intended purpose during exploration. A little nodding shit. Well, power slug. Uranium. Well, power slug. Not uranium, just the underside of the thingies. think we'll leave this up here. I'm thinking of like atop that rock over there. Is that an outcrop that even has a jumping puzzle? Or is it like pretty much jetpack or zipline climbing? I'm asleep now. This is what happens when you don't use the object scanner. You've got no idea where stuff is. That's glowing in the dark. That's a power slug. Just off in the distance over there. By them. Load up the man first. Fingers crossed that we get solid steel ingots. Now we've got to do that. Hopefully all that time messing about would mean that we have a surplus of steel beams. unless steel beams are on E2. And by surplus, I mean well on the way to, you know, actually filling the crate, as opposed to the piddly bits I was getting earlier. And I'm shifting the portable fueler out of the way, because, yeah, it's noticeably warm, but it's tolerably warm. As long as I keep hydrating. Yeah. A decent amount. If we only need like 450 or so to upgrade a line. Because we're not going to be riding the line to upgrade this, it's fine to start from this end. Alright, wrong line. E2 sorted first. Here as well. There we go. Staccatonus. Staccatonus? That sounds wrong. Like, see, that's on a Mark 1 belt that's running like vaguely smooth. That's E4. So I might have supply chain issues. But kind of stuck. Like, if I mess the Caterium ingot supply up. Let's get this one. I don't think I've got enough Mark II belt to run the rest of the line. That would have been E3 that I would have been upgrading, not E2. So E3 covers plates and rotors. And maybe modular frame? Yeah, we've got a bottleneck in here. That's Mark 2, and we only need 14 there. So, actually, I don't think we do have any bottleneck. So the bottleneck must be upstairs. We'll grab more beams while we're here. Get these checked on. B1 should have been taken care of, so we should be getting that stuff at a decent rate. Unless I've got a bottleneck in the belt line. There's a Mark 3 all the way across there. Looks like Mark 3 all the way across there. Which of these are steel beams again? Okay. This one's steel beams. Right? How much should it be spitting out? Should be getting 15 units a minute. Bottleneck and iron rods don't look going to do anything. Well, it might if we're redistributing stuff from here, but we're not. We're just producing over here. Mark 3, Mark 3. How much parts do we need? That needs Mark 1. That's running smoothly. That's going to need Mark 2. That's also running smoothly. I guess it's just staccato because it's saturated. Okay, let's head the drive. I'm hoping for some steel related recipes. Get solid steel ingot that's gonna reduce the required iron. I don't know if it increases or decreases or leaves the coal the same. Because at the moment it's 1:1:1 for iron and coal and steel ingot. If we get steel encased pipe, sort of steel encased beam, that's gonna like reshuffle the distribution of resources a bit. I think it's an overall reduction. But at the very least, it would reduce the amount of resources going to the steel beams floor. Steel rod would, I think, be the least useful of the useful steel recipes, because the primary advantage of steel rod is going to be solid steel ingots for the compound efficiencies granted. there we go. Right, now, do I get steel rod and then go and rebalance all of the steel recipes, or do I think ahead and get diluted packaged fuel for the upcoming oil shit? I think I'm going to do that. That means I can deploy the heavy residue byproduct recipes plus production, the sort of the polyres producing ones, and do some shit that way. I'll do both. Hang on a second. What recipes do I have access to now? I could actually produce polyres. And that's what we ended up aiming for in the first place. So what I could be doing when I spec up the inline manifolds for that is make the assumption that I'm going to be doing turbo fuel. But if it's blended turbo fuel, that means it needs a blender, and I don't have that unlocked, so I can't spec up the margins. Which means, assuming it is narrower than a refinery, we're not going to have that much of a problem. Horizontally. But lengthwise, along this way, because you'll have refinery and then refinery and packages, etc. And if the blender's shorter than the refinery, you'll just have a gap. Now the thing is, I'm pretty sure that the blender is wider than the refinery, so. Depth wise, that's like this way, the manifold spacing would be completely screwed. I don't wait, let's grab these ones as well. And these ones. Yeah, so those assemblers will have kicked in, and that's reduced it from 1,574 point whatever to 1,520. So I've got a little bit more headroom, but not as much as I would like. Oh, I need to get iron rod for the catwalks. Oh fuck. That was a mistake. That was another one. We'll get this aesthetic work done now though. bit uncomfortable with how close that is to the ground, but I wanted to just get it out of the way of this ship. Hopped on Discord there for a moment. That's run out of. But what we can do is finish this ship. Some windows there. Herbie. Nope. That did not have the desired effect. I was hoping I would have enough acceleration to land on here. Run out of Mark III belt parts, which looks like I might at this point be worth dropping Mark II belt part in, because that's going to increase the rate of motor production, which we're going to need soonish. Knock E2 off. The final sketch of V3 to get done. Let's total it up how much we need. We got 42 plus 6, that's 48 times 1. 2. Let's call that 3. I need 144 more steel beam. Is there? There we go. More or less where we wanted to land. That's going to take a little while to actually tot up. Good look at planning out the copper materium floors. Part of this, I've been continuously streaming for 6 hours. I don't think I've been streaming for 6 hours. I think our time has been kept going while I was offline, so let's reload that window. That's better. I've been streaming for an hour. Just go dump some of this back in the storage bin. The mortar production doing now. Not too bad. Don't have any, well, I'd say I don't have any chance. I don't have much chance of having like 3,000 wire lying around in total. Stop working again. Right, now the rotor building we can remove. Forgot about that shit. Drop those off as well. Oh no, wait, we still need that one. the sensible thing to do would be to dismantle the belts and point that merger in the other direction. I'd remove it entirely and stuff. But no, I'll just shove it in there. Let's go grab all of the copper wire. Might be able to get up to 2,500. I nearly grabbed that and it's like, They missed. Really want to come off for a nap now. Like, I know I've got steel beams to get deployed. definitely got enough steel beams now, so let's get this finished. I'll have a peek at A3 upstairs though. That's the core line, that only needs to be Mark 2. Yep, there we go. Bottleneck identified. Further bottleneck identified. E4 on Mark 2s, that's fine, but E3 has to be on Mark 3s. Now pop upstairs to check for bottlenecks. I should knock that off. Means I can knock that off. That means I can alt tab to bring up the to-do list, yay. Everything looks okay. Well, let's just clear it out and call it done then. A little bit more. You'll need to go spec out the oil, what's it? Not working, forgetting what the mouse wheel's for. I think I'm more of a due to do the copper and titanium facilities though, so let's get that sorted. Yeah, designed for copper and titanium facility. Frame and motor facility should be and equipment. Max file name size limit annoying. Would be adequately supplied, so it's not an assertion. Whereas I just said supplied, so it's an assertion, which might be wrong. Anyway, yeah. It's going to be off an hour. I think I need to go take a nap. I'm going to go rest my head. I'm not sure what I'll be streaming when I get back later. I'll find out. That's all for now. Good night.